One day, by a stroke of luck, a poor orphan named Dick Whittington found himself a cat. The two became close, and the cat proved very useful, working awfully hard for him. Before long, Whittington came to treasure the cat as an irreplaceable ally. And, sure enough, after he offered the cat to a merchant ship, Whittington suddenly acquired a massive fortune. This changed Whittington's life forever. But Whittington didn't simply use that fortune for his own benefit. He paid it back to the many people who had helped him over the years. Such philanthropy, coupled with his honest character, led him to marrying a wonderful wife. In time, he was even elected Lord Mayor of London. This is the story of Dick Whittington and his cat, one every good Brit knows well. However, whatever happened to the cat once it had brought good old Whittington all his copper and joy, you ask? Well, nobody seems to know. Not even Dick Whittington himself.
Well, this is it. Rainy woods. The way you'd want to come here. They used to call it the happiest town in the world. But that was over 30 years ago. Now I hear it's just fallen to bits and full of weirdos. If it's sightseeing you're after, you'd be better off heading somewhere like Windermere or Grassmere. To each your own, I suppose. Enjoy your holiday, then.
What a goddamn hellhole.
This is Naomi Haywood, a photographer from New York. Now, why would someone like Naomi come to this far-flung corner of England? Because of all the interesting things to photograph, of course. That's the official line, anyway. Her true reasons lie elsewhere. A certain client has asked Naomi to investigate a secret. And she's hoping this job will help her escape a colossal mountain of debt. Who is this client? Well, that'll become clear soon enough. Let's just see what happens next, shall we? Well then, are you ready?
Ah! Don't they have pest control around here? You got any idea how much these sunglasses cost? Goddamn hellhole!
Welcome to Rainy Woods. This is the happiest town in the world. We're delighted to have you here. How do you do? What? Thank you.
Jeez. Seriously? Jeez.
Thank you.
All right there.
Yeah. How do you do?
If you would.
Good day.
Oh, jeez. How do you do? Right.
How are you?
Hey!
Hmm.
Seriously?
If you would.
How goes it? Right. Thanks, as always.
Town's been hiding a rather beastly secret.
Now this is one hell of a scoop. Elizabeth? Hold on! Hey, lady! Why are you the only one who's still normal?
Thank you.
Do you realise what you just stepped into, sweetheart? People round here call this place the witch's house.
The witch's house?
Bum da da da! I'm Pauline Atwood, but everyone calls me the Woodland Witch. Ha! Huh? What's that?
Seriously?
Yeah. was that? Oh?
What the... Everyone's back to normal.
Why, good morning. Lovely day, innit?
Elizabeth. That's right. The church's bell tower. The witch's concoction is supposed to make me higher than a kite. Time to give this thing a try. so my next report's gonna be a real doozy, huh? No way! This blaze. Goddamn hellhole.
Afterwards, Naomi returned to the Woodland Witch and told her what had happened. But the witch just feigned ignorance, claiming her concoction was just a type of natural sedative, the dodgy kind of substance that has somehow skirted the definition of legal. She said she only made it up because Naomi looked so distressed. And it certainly wasn't capable of doing anything as preposterous as turning a person into an animal. According to Pauline, when Naomi saw the townspeople turning into animals, it was actually a hallucination caused by the stress of moving to a brand new place. Naturally, Naomi's client wouldn't be happy to receive such a report. And so it seemed Naomi would not be free of her debts anytime soon. Keep your chin up, Naomi. In the 17th century, England experienced two revolutions, the Puritan Revolution and the Glorious Revolution. After the death of Oliver Cromwell, leader of the Puritan Revolution, the House of Stuart returned to power. Charles II, also known as the Merry Monarch, was next to succeed the throne. Charles II is said to have loved dogs and always carried one wherever he went. He even posted a reward in the newspapers when his beloved dog went missing. This act was laughed off by his people as yet another one of their king's eccentricities. Proof that as a dog lover, Charles II was far ahead of his time. But being a dog lover was not the only thing Charles II was famous for. Wars against other countries, religious issues, conflicts with Parliament, the Great Plague and the Great Fire. His government was constantly deep in the red and even had to temporarily declare bankruptcy at one point. Just 3 years after his death, the Glorious Revolution shook England. But even though his reign had ended, Charles's legacy did not. The Cavalier King Charles Spaniel. Even now, Charles II's favourite breed of dog is still beloved around the world.
Bye.